Good morning, friends. Today we are discuss about the larval forms. Larval forms. There are the different larval forms. First, we are seen about the amphiblastula larva. Amphiblastula larva. Amphiblastula larva is the characteristic larval form of the class Calcarea of phylum Porifera. Phylum Porifera. That is a Porifera. Porifera is the phylum in which pore bearing animal included. Okay, it is a oval in shape. If we are seen about this diagram, then we can see the oval shape. It is a oval in shape and consists of the two part. First one is a upper part and second one is the lower part. First upper part is a one half has a small narrow flagellated cells. In this diagram we can see flagellated micromeres. These are the half small narrow flagellated cells, and below these are the lower part. These lower part is a non-flagellated micromeres. That is a non-flagellated micromeres. Because it is composed of the two different regions, that is the A, suppose we consider as a A and we consider as a P. These both the parts are hollow. This larval type is known as a amphiblastula larva, right? Amphiblastula larva. This amphiblastula larva, when fully formed in the parent body, the larva is set free in a radial canal and finally exit through the osculum along with the water current. After it releases in water current, they are swimming for some time with the help of flagella. These are the flagellated micromeres, and with the help of this flagella, these larva is swimming for some time. That is the near about 6 to 7 hours, or maybe a less or more. After swimming for the few hours, gastrulation take place by the invagination of flagellated cells. Now the larva become a typical gastrula with the blastopore at the invaginated site. The larva attached to the some rock bites blastoporal end and develop into the young sponge. These are the amphiblastula larvae.